Hi. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to your fantastic Monday, April 25th, 2022, episode 221. Today we're going to be talking about Full of Joy. Beginning with John 15:11, our recommended reading today is Psalm 16:8 through 11. Our turning point is from A. B. Simpson. A. B. is initials, and then Simpson. A. B. Simpson. And our Bible reading today is 2 Kings 19 through 21. 19, 20, and 21. So, get it? 221? 21? Hey, that's a good coincidence on that one. But I just finished recording last night's Turning Point, and I'm going on recording tonight's your Monday Turning Point, because hopefully today we had your days of praise, your daily bread were involved in a live stream. If not, it's recorded. It'd be pre-recorded and turn around and posted. So, it's either going to be live or pre-recorded. I don't know. At this time, I don't know what it's going to be. But I hope it went live stream. If not, then I had to record it and post it. But I hope you enjoyed it. So, I'll be trying to tell you what's going, give you a preview of tonight's video in that. So, of this video in the end of that, whichever it is, live or pre-recorded. So hopefully it'll be live. Many times before when I've had live streams, it's not worked. The last two or three times I've tried live stream, it's been so daggum. I mean, it would work for about 5 minutes and start messing up. And then it was like I kept jumping and jumping and jumping, and finally I had to just say, cut it off, go in, record your video. Hopefully I don't say nothing that I don't forget if I have to record it. So, at least it would be day of recording, not pre-recorded the night before. So, it's not like I recorded it tonight and showing it tomorrow. Those episodes are on the day it's supposed to be. So, I think 600 was like that. Had to pre-record it, turn around and post it the same day, the same time. As soon as I got it done editing, I went in, boop. And then I had already had it all edited, because I had done it ahead of schedule. So sometime IRL tomorrow, which is Sunday, I'll try to sit down and get it scheduled for today. I'll get it scheduled for, hopefully it went off between 1:30 and 2 o'clock. It's usually when I do it. If I do it live, it's usually right between 1:30 and 2 o'clock. So sometimes I do it, I might start early, and other times I might start a little late. Depends on what I'm doing. So, but sorry for rambling about that, but let's get to it. If you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. Comment something that happened today. If something special happened today, what was it? But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark by May 31st, which should be real close. May 31st, I should be real close to hitting the 2-year mark, not only on YouTube, but in videos. Because I'll have 2 years worth of videos. Which will be episode 730. So that should be right around right around my 2-year on YouTube mark. So, but Full of Joy, John 15:11 says, "These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full." So let's see if I don't see that passage nowhere on the list, so I guess I'll read the first two sections, then I'll read the recommended reading, and then finish it up. So that'll sound good. So in the New Testament epistles, joy or rejoice are mentioned some 50 times. What is surprising is that Jesus, in John's Gospel, only broaches the subject of joy some 10 times, only a half a dozen of which are related to personal joy. And guess where Jesus raised the subject of joy with his disciples? Any thoughts? In the upper room.
The upper room.
On the night of his betrayal and arrest, John 13-17. So he did it at the Lord's table, basically, is what you at the Last Supper. So why did Jesus focus on joy during his last night with his disciples? Because he knew what was coming. He knew that the tribulation that lay ahead for him would tempt the disciples to lose their hope, to lose their joy. And before leaving the upper room, he said to them, "These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." John 16:33, with emphasis added. And because Jesus would overcome the world, the disciples could keep their joy. So before going any further, let's turn in our Bibles to Psalm 16. Turn right to it again. Dadgummit, I'm getting pretty good at turning to the passage I need to. Psalm 16:8-11. Says, I have set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. That's a song. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved, or something. I don't remember the jingle. Sorry about that. Bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves. Sorry about that. So therefore, my heart is glad, and my glory rejoices. My flesh also will rest in hope, for you will not leave my soul in hell, or Sheol. Nor will you allow your Holy One to see corruption. You will show me the path of life, and your presence is fullness of joy, and at your right hand are pleasures forevermore. So in the world trying to, is the world trying to steal your joy today? So Jesus has overcome the world, and in him our joy is made full. Amen? So today's turning point is from A. B. Simpson. And he says, "It is his joy that remains in us that makes our joy full." Amen? It's his joy that makes our joy full. Get it? And today's Bible reading, I don't remember if I said it, but it's 2 Kings 19:20-21. And that coexists with 21, with episode 221. I just thought you would like that. But coming up tomorrow, in tomorrow's turning point, we have, I'm going to do it like I normally do it. Tomorrow, we're going to be, your morning video, we'll be talking about Ancient Times, episode 701, part 1, beginning with Psalm 77, verse 5, compiled from Henry M. Morse. 701, part 2, for your terrific Tuesday, April 26th. We're gonna be learning about age is just a number. From Marvin Williams, derived from 1 Timothy 4, 16 or 6 through 13. And in tomorrow night's Turning Point, we're going to be learning about being precious in His sight. Beginning with Psalm 116, 15, and it'll be episode 222. Our recommended reading will be Psalm 72, 14. And our turning point is from Alistair Begg, A-L-I-S-T-A-I-R-A-I-R-B-E-G-G. And the Bible reading is 2 Kings 22 and 23. 22, 222, 22, 23. A lot of twos in that one. And then 72. There's a lot of twos in that passage for tomorrow. But stay tuned for those. I'll be getting to those sometime tonight. And hopefully get them out for tomorrow. And hopefully do Wednesdays as well. But until then, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. I hope the live stream went off well today. If not, then a pre-recorded video was posted. But until tomorrow, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022. And until then, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your fantastic Monday evening. Come back tomorrow for another terrific Tuesday. And I'll see everybody then. Goodbye.